Commander, you need to find Vulcan and Prometheus stations and override the lockdown from each facility. Doesn't matter which one you hit first, but you can't enter Atlas Station until you've dealt with both. Also, keep an eye out for Cerberus security mechs. The VI has likely taken control of them. Archer out.
This is at least a more interesting usage of the Hammerhead than Firewalker did. Well, you got a much nicer area to explore as well. Waterfalls, very nice planet. Instead of being given a map, we have a proximity detector, and these arrows are flying from the Hammerhead to indicate the rough direction of station. You can't just go in a straight line, however, as you can see.
Geographic conditions indicate an aesthetically pleasing view nearby. Organic life forms may wish to take note.
He's talking about this view. And it is very nice. So, thanks for that, I suppose. Wait, what are those? Some kind of cow-like creature. And I know it's cruel, but... Well,
analysis. Defenseless herbivores are no match for guided missiles.
Indeed. They're not. I know that's cruel, but it's funny to have him say that. Alright. Looks like we're going that way. So far, no sign of any resistance. Unless you want to count the cows. If I'm not mistaken... Yes, there's something down there. Including an Emirmac. Apparently. And something we can collect. And because the Hammerhead can take absolutely no punishment, this kind of thing can get interesting. Looks like somebody crashed a car here.
An emergency Cerberus data packet has been recovered. It contains information on Project Overlord that other research cells need to review. Be alert for more packets in the area. 5 more remain.
So that's a minor side quest here, to find the data packets. First time I played the game, I did not find all of them, and this one was actually the one I didn't find. Got all others, not this one. Because, you know, unless you think to look down below the waterfall, you never notice that there is something down there. The others are much easier to find. There is another one here. See there.
Another Cerberus data packet has been recovered. 4 more remain.
That would normally be the first one you get. So let's go to Vulcan Station. You don't have to do them in this order. I think you can also do the other one first, but since the Hammerhead points you to this one first, it's kind of obvious to do this one. And we get to do more hammerheading. Yes, that's a verb now. And we get to pick a new team. Somehow. Not entirely sure how that works. Let's go with... Zaid and Jacob. Three points for Jacob, which I can't do anything with. That's kind of badly done by me. Waste a lot of points that way. So Ida 6 points, so he gets one more thing. I think I'm going to use disruptor ammo, because one of the interesting things about disruptor ammo, or any ammo power when you evolve them, is that you can actually give it to the entire squad. And we can choose between heavy disruptor ammo. This ammunition's electromagnetic properties can cause synthetics to critically overload and explode. Or squad disruptor ammo. Your entire squad gains the disruptor ammo's effects, allowing you to catch synthetics in deadly crossfires. So that's not just useful for him, it's useful for all of us. And it's also something I haven't shown yet, so...
Scanning area. Analysis. VI infection is present within plant machinery. Advise caution.
Yes, especially if they're disrupting our communications. Also, lava. Since the hammerhead can get destroyed by a light breeze, you might imagine that lava is not good for it. So best stay clear. How are we gonna get up there?
Scanning area. Analysis. Venting stations provide adequate velocity to enhance vehicle lift.
Ah, okay. Well, I guess we can't jump up there. But seems that our VI thinks we can use these. Not there, though. We have to use these last ones so that can boost us up to the ridge. Wow, we went high. Turrets. We'll get to deal with those a lot in this mission. Also being controlled by the VI. Not sure which way to go. Resources, by the looks of it. The data packets have this thing in the middle of them, so they look different. Plus, I don't think you find any data packets on missions. Only in the connecting area.
Analysis. Debris field provides adequate support for vehicle.
Okay, so apparently now we're playing Frogger. But these things sink if you stay on them, so keep moving! Okay, that last jump didn't really work as intended, but we made it anyway. Nothing here. Looks like we're using another one of these vents to get up. Ow.
Thruster velocity is inadequate to clear the wall ahead.
Now what do you know? He's right. I guess we need to fix that by going into this building. I already did that.
Warning. Automated controls are offline. Core systems have...
How the hell did you get there? So, now if we let Zaid use his disruptor ammo, you'll see that my weapons also get it, as well as Jacob's. I think Jacob actually has an ammo power himself. Oh, he also has squat ammo power, so I did already show that. Well, anyway, we have synthetics here, so I guess that the Raptor ammo is more useful.
Incoming. This should take the heat off.
As long as it's only mechs, then... not exactly, trouble anyway, with or without ammo powers. I thought I hadn't shown that before, but apparently I had.
Warning. Pressure levels in valve A3 have exceeded maximum threshold. Manual control is required.
Okay. So this system can determine that that has happened,
warning.
But can't actually, bypass it himself, itself, whatever. It's not a good design. I mean, I'm assuming this is kind of like a VI system. So, if it can detect the problem, why not allow it to fix the problem? So now we can use that to continue our way. And it seems the VI Cum David is not happy about that. Not getting much out of that, are we? So let's resume our journey in the Hammerhead. Only barely made it. For some reason, what we just did also turned the lights on here. Turrets! Great. You know I love turrets. Am I actually hitting it? Every time we kill one of these things, the VI yells out. Oh great, this again. We get to do it for a considerably longer distance this time. Because we kind of have to go forward. Not particularly difficult, but if you do make a mistake, it's kind of annoying. What's up here? Oh, I seem to remember this. Ah, okay, that didn't work. Turrets. And there's two of them, and considering the minimal amount of damage that the Hammerhead can take, you really don't want to go up there while they're still around. Because there's no cover or anything. So the only way to get what's up here is to do it this way, basically. The slow but safe way. Well, that's one. That's the I'm damaged sound. Did we get it? Yes. Oh, no. Ah! Keyboard not cooperating. I'm smoking and everything. There. And what did we get for all that trouble? Some resources. That was really worth it. Looks like we can go up the other side too. And more resources. Interesting. That's where we went inside before, and then we kind of drove around, it seems. But where we actually want to go is over there. I mean, this is a nice view and everything, but how come there is lava this close to such a nice area as we were in before? Now we have to go against the street. Just another touch of difficulty at it. You can sort of jump while you're in the air, but it's not very effective. And it seems this is our stop. Still have disruptor ammo. But the other two don't. How the hell does that work? There. I loved the squad ammo thing when I played as a soldier myself, because then you have almost all the ammo powers. You have like incendiary ammo and cryo ammo. So you could just pick what to give to whatever you want, to whoever you want.
Have exceeded maximum threshold. Manual control is required.
Okay. I guess we better do that. What's over there? Explosive container. I'm gonna blow some debris out of the way. Does that make any difference? We're going upstairs now, but what's downstairs? Other than a data pad. I don't remember!
Eyes ahead!
Ah, okay. You can't actually go this way, it seems. How sneaky of them to make us think that we could. No. Knowing that there's an actual person behind, these yells makes them even creepier, I think. Not just a VI. It's a person!
Barriers up!
Alright, there's drones. I think
charging.
Yep. That's one way to deal with the drones.
Gun.
Overload also works.
Not only
There. My timing could have been better on that. Well, anyway. Anything here? Except more corpses? Doesn't look like it. Well, let's keep moving, find that override. And I guess we're going this way. What's over here? Just ammo. That's kind of useless. Let's check what's behind this door. A wall safe. And a research log.
Received an SOS from Atlas Station. Archer has declared a project emergency. We're trying to shut down the power generators to starve the VI, but it's already hacked our automated systems. I'm ordering my people to sabotage the plant any way they can.
They're trying to shut down the power. I don't like being watched. Wait, if that's true, then why am I making videos for the interwebs?
They've seen us.
There. Well, I was trying to watch that one. You two might want to consider actually helping. And an Ymir mech. Got him! Too far away to use overload on them. Still, just snipe them. Whatever David has become, killing all these people was not exactly a good thing. Oh, I guess we could have dealt with these drones that way as well. Oh well. Too late for that now. And another door to bypass. Kind of an unusual layout. It's trying to shoot the override.
I hear you, Doctor. We've hit the override at Vulcan Station and are moving on. Shepard out.
Why is that even a renegade interrupt? It's just shooting a mech. Well, that's one lockdown. Successfully issued override command from Vulcan Station. 12 experience, which is useless, 9,000 credits, which are not useless, 2,000 iridium. Well, now we just got to override the lockdown at Prometheus Station, and then on to Atlas. And I'd also like to find those other four data packets. So let's see if we can find them.
Geographic conditions indicate an aesthetically pleasing view nearby.
Yeah, yeah.
Organic life forms may wish
We've
to
seen it. I wonder what's up here. It's not where we're supposed to go, but... Who knows, there might be a data packet or something. Well, there's definitely something.
Scans indicate VI infection is present in nearby turrets.
More turrets to deal with. And what did that get us? Yes, another data packet.
Another Cerberus data packet has been recovered. Three more remain.
Let's see if we can find those. Some kind of flying creatures there. Not sure if they're birds or flying reptiles. What's up there?
Threat detection. Enemy units nearby.
Help! Okay, that could have gone better. Still hitting it? I have no idea. Probably not. I think I got it. Yes. And what's over here? Probably another data packet. Somewhere. There it is. The hell?
Another Cerberus data packet has been recovered. Two more remain.
Well, that's good. I I'm pretty sure that that's where the last one is, up that ridge. Let's go to that first. Well, the not the last one, but I happen to know the real last one is near the entrance to Atlas Station. So we'll do that one. Naturally, we'll come across that one while we're going there. Let's do the first five before heading to Prometheus. Probably gonna be more turrets, aren't there?
Hostile activity detected.
Yep. It is going back underground. This is really annoying when you,
another Cerberus data packet has been recovered.
If you die, because it will restore you last time you started in the Hammer Hat, which is after we came out of Vulcan Station, so we would have lost the other two data packets as well. Alright, now let's go to Prometheus, which is this way apparently. More of them cow-like things there. But we are not interested in them. Be getting closer.